Hello everyone, welcome to the Red Men TV. Things have finally died down here outside Anfield. It was Liverpool 4, Red Bull Salzburg 3 in one of the balmiest games of football I've ever watched in my entire life. It's what it feels like to be alive! At 40 minutes, I honestly thought, and I think it's at a half-time shame, that was the best performance I think I've ever seen from Liverpool in 30 years of coming here to watch the Reds. That was the best. We were creative but clinical. It was like watching a master surgeon at work or whatever. Not that I've ever done that, but I imagine it would be. Just carved them apart when we needed to. We were strong and we were physical, and they threatened us in there. And you know, when a team's so good, we were so good that when we were making mistakes or just slightly missing it in the ball, and it was still working out for us. And I've never seen Liverpool so good that you'd even get the rubber of the green in those things. And then I don't know what it was, and because it's hard, because obviously I've just walked out the ground and we've just done a few videos and it's been chaos around here, people jumping up and down. So I haven't obviously seen it back yet, but it just felt like we just got a touch complacent, maybe. A little bit lax, and I think it went through the crowd and the players as well. We were absolutely in cruise control, and it felt like we were just going to stroll our way through, score a few more goals, and go on to a really, really comfortable victory. And, you know, Jürgen Klopp was at lengths to say pre-match, these are a good team, they're going to surprise a few people. I didn't expect at 3-0 up for them to surprise us quite the way they did, but particularly in the second half when they came out, we just didn't click back into gear. Normally we're so much better at the start of halves, like we figured things out and we adapt what we're doing, but it actually felt like the flip reverse. It felt like they worked us out to some extent, and then they got better as the second half continued. And it was like watching us from last year or a little bit of the year before, particularly in the Champions League, where all of a sudden they just had more men on the field than us. They were overloading. They just seemed to be more men, but they had more width, more guile, more penetration. And it felt inevitable that they'd get the 3-0, but I'll be perfectly honest, and a lot of people have come up to me and said, like, oh, I didn't enjoy that, or it was terrible, or oh, shocking. I really enjoyed that game of football, because I never felt for a single second like we wouldn't win it. And maybe that's just me. Maybe it's easy to say in hindsight, but genuinely, this side is so good, and we've got goals in us, and we had that positive change. We did the same at Sheffield United as well. We were a little bit more gung-ho, a little bit more attacking. We actually could have scored a couple more goals, to be fair. Bit of wasteful finishing, and you know, a couple of off nights, it's weird. We're talking about Mo Salah with 2 goals tonight, and probably had a bit of an off night, to be perfectly honest. Things are just not sticking for him, they're not dropping in the right way for him, and what have you. And you know, we that should have been a 5 or a 6-0. We should have, our concentration level should have been better, and we should have been a little bit more clinical. But the best thing about that is we've got the ability to flex those muscles. And you know, we keep saying it in years gone by, Liverpool completely full. But think about like the Sevilla games 2 seasons ago, our heads would have gone completely, and we'd have been clinging on for dear life there. Whereas, if I go back and rewatch it, maybe I will feel more nervous. I know certainly there were people around me who were nervous, but there was a real sense every goal they scored, like everyone went, huh. And then there just goes a roar comes up from the crowd again, and we start singing again, and then we go, and then unfortunately they scored again and again and again. Funniest moment of the match is probably the fact that the scoreboard said it was 3-3 at 3-1, and we laughed, not thinking that was possible in this game. And as it turns out, it was very. But the most important thing is that we've got that fourth goal, put the game to bed. A little moment where I was just thinking, oh my god, is this going to be our VAR get fucked by VAR moment? Mercifully no. And look, getting the 3 points was all that was necessary there for Liverpool, just to make sure that we had them in the bag. And you know, the Leicester game coming up at the weekend is the one we can focus on now, because that's where we're at. That's what the group stage is all about, and I think we showed there. I think, look, they're going to cause problems. They might well cause Napoli problems, which is going to make this group very, very interesting. But yeah, You've got to enjoy this. If you're a fan of football, then you should probably have enjoyed that game. I know I did. And if you did, let me know in the comments below. Let me know your thoughts in general on the match. Make sure you subscribe. And if you want more as well, there's the player ratings, which is absolutely fantastic. And there'll be the instant match reaction show, 15 minutes, talking about this in more depth and detail on the redmentv.com.